Hey guys, so today we're gonna do a video response.
Hi! My name is not Sven, it is Martin, yeah.
Okay, so this is gonna be like video response 2.0 because it's gonna be sort of a reprise, a coming back to a video response I did several years ago, and the video response is to Michael Buckley's Getting to Know You series, or whatever we want to call it, where he asks us a certain amount of questions plus a few bonus questions, so let's do it.
What is your name?
Martin Arverbro.
How old are you?
I am 33 years, 2 months and 6 days old.
Where do you live? Where have you lived?
I live in Karlskrona. I'm originally from Malmö. I've also lived in Stockholm, in Bergen, Norway, and in Gold Coast, Australia.
Do you have any pets?
I have 2 rescue cats. This one is Snuttan, who is, I don't know, many years old. We've had her since 2005. And this is Lille Snuttan, a very temporary rescue cat, but she's been here for 2 years now.
What would you do if you won $100 million?
If I had $100 million, well, I would probably not keep those $100 million because I seriously believe that you cannot really be happy with too much money. I would probably set things up. I would upgrade, like, equipment-wise. I would probably travel a lot and see places that I want to see, but, you know, where money and time is an issue, so, no, but not too much money.
What magazines do you subscribe to?
People still subscribe to magazines?
What's your favorite TV show on the air right now?
Favorite shows include Big Bang Theory, I like that, I like New Girl, I like Williams Lista, which is a Swedish YouTuber on Swedish state TV web series. Very cool.
Who's your favorite YouTuber besides Buck?
Favorite YouTubers for me mostly means smaller YouTubers, people I know, friends of mine. I still follow a couple of the bigger ones, but you know, I've never really been the person who follows because they're big. I mean, seriously, I haven't seen a single Smosh video. Seriously.
What's your favorite song right now? End of all time?
That is a tricky one. Okay, how about Samson by Regina Spektor? Just kind of found that and I love that song. Great song. Favorite song of all times, I would probably say Music by John Miles. The live version.
What are you most proud of in your life?
Well, one of the things I'm proud of is the fact that 2 people met through a video that I did in the comment section. They now have a baby. Although I didn't intentionally do a whole lot in, you know, to do that. I just kind of, in a weird way, provided that situation to occur.
What kind of friend are you?
I am definitely the listening type. Someone once told me that, Martin, you're a good listener. You should be a priest. And I said, can I just be a good friend?
Describe your personal style.
Well, one of the things that, you know, why Michael Buckley, why you, Michael, resonate so well with me is that I can recognize a lot of your trademarks in myself, even though you're older than me. And on the one hand, especially on this channel, where I'm just like, I'm a loud personality, I'm a big personality, especially in my car vlogs, I will scream and sing and stuff. But at the same time, like you have your Prone 75 channel, I also have this very heavily thinking, emotional side. I mean, I've even cried in videos online. So you have this spectrum between the completely outrageous and the very, very deep things and all the things between it. Because life is about all the emotions, not just the straight line of doing things, but actually kind of, you know, moving back and forth, you know, or at least allowing it to happen when it happens. So,
bonus questions! What's your favorite What the Buck topics?
I would probably say the things that you are really, really, really into when it comes to, like, the Olympics, when you talk about the figure skating and stuff like that. The stuff that you're really, like, one of the experts on, and when you're really passionate about things, I would say, yeah.
What's your least favorite What the Buck topics?
It's probably the ones that I can't really relate to at all, like when you talk about, you know, The View, because, you know, we don't have that show over here, so that's probably more of a geographical, you know, problem.
Should What the Buck Show break up in several videos?
Yes, absolutely. The thing is, you know, classic, you know, YouTube rule, you know, classic Vlogbrothers rule, don't go over 4 minutes. And lately, a lot of your videos have been like the 9-10 minutes, and they become a little bit long, especially when you have multiple topics. So I would probably do that, split it up into like the source-fed format of covering, you know, topics. And the thing is, you can always, like, and then the next video will be at the end, so you can always kind of keep people going so that they see like the entire 10-minute episode in, you know, just split up in 3 or 4 depending on the number of topics. Because yes, it'll probably make the thumbnails and the titling a lot easier. All right, so that was me answering a few questions based on the questions I got from What the Buck Show, Michael Buckley, the first YouTuber I ever subscribed to. And his second channel was the second YouTuber I ever subscribed to. So if you want to do this as well, it's kind of like one of those memes where you answer questions, just read out the questions below, watch Michael's video, and have yourself a really, really swell day. Bye-bye now. See? Big personality.
Thank you for 3,000 laddies!